Morning, everyone. Delighted to be here, and thank you to the Exchange for Media team to have me here today. So actually, the topic I'm going to talk about is quite contrary to what most of you will think about marketing, and that's the title of my presentation, right? It's not about building brands, it's about building categories. And let me walk you through the principles of how and why that's important, and more importantly, bring it alive with examples from what Swiggy's done over the last decade by adhering to these principles. So the big thing is, all of us must remember that I want you to walk away remembering is that think categories, not brands, and you're more likely to win in the future and in the marketplace. So let's start with. So sorry, if you can, the speaker notes are on the last slide, if you can go back to the first slide. Let's start with what my definition of marketing is. When I ask this question in a room, many times I get very, very different answers. It's advertising, it's creating demand, it's sales, all sorts of things. But these five words for me are my favorite definition of marketing, which is it's about meeting consumer needs profitably and sustainably. Every one of these words are important because first, we're all here as businesses to solve consumer problems, delight their lives in whatever situations that our business meets their needs in. So it's doing that. When you do that well, you win in the marketplace. Why is it important to do it profitably? Ultimately, profits help businesses thrive, and then it's a virtuous loop. Economies, systems thrive. So if you don't do it profitably, it's not worth it. And increasingly, sustainably is going to become even more important. All of us already know about it. It wasn't there in the lexicon maybe 5, 6 years ago, but we all know that businesses that plunder aren't going to survive in the long run, right? Businesses that thrive along with the rest of the planet are what's going to succeed in the long run. So both of these are important. So if you think about this, then how do you therefore think about category building? Here are the three things that I'd say are principles that you must follow. First is you've got to define the category that you're in very, very sharply and clearly, and I'll elucidate that with examples later. The next, once you define the category that you're in, you've got to keep educating consumers about what the category, how it's relevant, what are the benefits, what are the features that it offers for you to make the life of that consumer better. This is an ongoing thing. It might sound boring after a point of time, but it's the rigor that we need to keep doing all the time. And the last is to keep innovating, because if you don't innovate, that's when competitors catch up, that's when you fail to keep up with times, etc., and then you don't become synonymous with the category. If you think of all the great brands that you remember, they're almost always synonymous with the category or a subcategory. And that comes with doing these three things brilliantly, which is defining the space that you're in, constantly educating consumers about what the category does for them, and innovating to keep moving it a notch up, right? So now coming to Swiggy's journey, I think she talked about it. All of us know that Swiggy's three big businesses are food delivery, quick commerce, and dining out. But that's not how the founders thought about the businesses. The mission statement and a truncated version of that is this: that we are here to deliver joy by offering unparalleled convenience. And I love it because we're in the business of delivering joy, frankly, and we're in the business of making life more convenient. And then suddenly, the definition turns from brands to the category of inconveniences that consumers face to benefits that we can offer in terms of making life far more convenient. And therefore, wherever there are conveniences, micro, macro, that's where Swiggy thinks, saying, hey, these are problems that we can end up solving for consumers, and how do we therefore build businesses and the brand to thrive? So with that in mind, if you can think, go back in time, this is how food delivery was born, and it's a very interesting story when you speak to the founders. Two young guys, hungry, couldn't cook, said, hey, we need to find an easier way to get food to ourselves. And they found that, this is 10 years ago, many of you who are youngsters, students, may not even understand this, but back then, ordering food was difficult, is what they said, right? Either restaurants were barely available, you had to call them directly. More often than not, you had to pay by cash. Deliveries are always batched, which means they'd have 2, 3 customers' deliveries together. It'll either turn up cold or late, wasn't often reliable. Menus weren't easy to access, so it wasn't the easiest. It was quite an inconvenient process. So that was the big innovation. That's how Swiggy was born, saying, hey, we need to make this far easier. So if you see this old screenshot of how the app looked, one of the big things which we take for granted today is putting images on the menu card. That itself, and there's data and evidence to show that even today there are some restaurants which don't have images of their food, massive difference in how much sales rate or sales growth that they get. Just looking at those images also I think the brain just gets a little bit more hungry when you see those images, but it definitely makes a massive difference. Small innovation, large impact. Lots of restaurants. So it's not just about having one or two neighborhood restaurants that you can reach out to, but suddenly the number of restaurants that you can access and therefore the kind of food that you can have at your home goes up dramatically and therefore builds the category. And the third, it's not very clear here, but this is the post-order tracking screen. It's a remarkable innovation, but I want to talk about the version one of this innovation. So all of you remember, try and remember 10 years ago, if you did order something and you wanted it, what would you do? You'd have to keep calling the guy, chasing up, you don't know what happened. But here's the ingenuity that the founder showed back then. So they had three numbers, and back then, by the way, smartphones weren't as prevalent. So delivery partners had basic mobile phones. So what they do is, when they arrive at the restaurant, they give a missed call to a number, which will send an SMS to the customer saying, delivery partner arrived at the restaurant. When they then picked up the order, they give a missed call to another number, which will then send the next SMS to the customer saying, order picked up. And then once they reached the destination, third missed call saying, order has arrived. This was the first most rudimentary form of what is today a post-order tracking screen. Sounds, on hindsight, very intuitive, but a fair amount of ingenuity to invent something like that. And now today, all of us, I know, the minute you order, you're constantly looking at your track screen. Where's my delivery? Has it picked up? Is he on its way? Is he ahead of time? So it's a phenomenal innovation. And that made delivery very, very reliable, which is one of the core problems that this business is solving for. And the screen that you see here came up sometime in 2015 and thereafter. And like I said, today we take for granted. Now that most delivery partners, almost all of them have smartphones, etc., this is obviously a much more efficient solution. So this is the founding part of the food delivery business. And these are the three benefits that we want to keep saying, hey, you can get food fast, you can get access to lots of restaurants, and you can order whatever value that you want. And that's what formed the bedrock of the marketing campaign that happened a couple of years later. So I'm going to show these and I'm going to ask them to play the first three videos. And I'm sure it evokes a lot of memories for many of you.
And run out. The team's in desperate need of a miracle here.
Get food super fast. Swiggy. Water delivery.
He's looking for a single. And he sneaks one in there.
Even the smallest food orders delivered. Swiggy. Water delivery.
Bisi wali baat?
No sir, kathi roll.
Bisi wali baat?
No sir, hakka noodles.
Bisibalabad.
No sir, pasta.
Macha, was this your Bisibalabad?
And taken.
Deadly it was.
Thousands of restaurants to choose from. Swiggy, water delivery.
Fairly iconic pieces of communication. And the Gulab Jamun uncle became synonymous with Swiggy. In fact, that Mr. Naresh Goel, his people call him Gulab Jamun uncle only. And people have made ads with him, casting him as Gulab Jamun uncle in many different things. So amazing stuff. But this is the foundation of what's built this category, which is today over 4 million orders a day. The category, 70,000 crore category in the year and growing at 20%. So that's the bedrock of what built the category. Then moving on to what are the innovations that keep solving more inconveniences and problems. Here's one, again, not very clear, but we have a screen on the app, which is a reorder screen. What we find is there are very often that you have your go-to restaurants and your go-to items, right? So how do we reduce the number of clicks that it takes for you to go from, yeah, I want to do that, to place the order? In fact, this is the innovation that happened, and the team has taken it from 9 clicks down to 3 clicks and dramatically saves time, and it happens so much faster. And we find close to 3.5 lakh users using this feature every day. Generates incremental business as well for us because you're able to do it much faster. So the minute you eliminate friction, can the speaker nights slide move as well, please? It eliminates friction and therefore grows the category. The second innovation, the more recent one, which I feel very excited about, is this. It's called group ordering. I just want a show of hands. How many of you in the room have ever obviously had a gathering at home and said, let's all order food at home and keep walking around to each of them saying, what do you want? What do you want? Has ever had that experience? Most of you. It's quite painful, isn't it? That, And then there's always somebody changing their mind, somebody having some specifications. What if you just put the power of that decision making in their own individual hands? That's exactly what the feature is about. Saying the lead person can open a cart, share a QR code, goes to everyone's mobiles. Each one is then individually adding the food that they want onto that cart. Fantastic, right? Then comes back to the final person. Of course, if you think somebody's ordered too much, you can always delete it. But you can finally place the order, one shot, pay, boom, done. No more pain, no more fights, no more annoyance. Just a much easier, frictionless process. This has just gone live a few weeks ago, and we're already seeing like over 6% of the platform users adopting it. In fact, there's a number that the largest number we first saw within the week was 17 people creating a cart together, and during Rakhi, which is when people gather and there are family occasions, etc., 34 people did a large group order. And all of these order values, as you can understand, are higher than the average order value on the platform because these are large group orders. Again, a great example for me of solving a consumer problem, helping build the category as well. Okay, and then coming to quick commerce, back in the day, 2020, when this was pioneered by the team, this is how it looked. The early days, they said, okay, why don't we find a way to deliver groceries as well from nearby stores to consumers? But wasn't reliable, wasn't easy, because availability of the SKUs were patchy, partner availability wasn't always consistent. So we said, hey, this isn't working out. So actually, the team then took a very contrarian view. And remember, this was during COVID when this phenomenon was born, saying that everybody is talking about price. Everyone's talking about stock up in a category, which is grocery. Most of us tend to buy at the end of the month, big packs, best price. Convenience was not even talked about. It was taken a complete back seat. So they said, hey, why don't we do an antithesis of that? And say, this is about convenience, this is about top-up, this is about the 3,000 SKUs that we can offer you, but with control in our hands, not in different shops' hands, where therefore we can provide a much better customer experience. So that's how it started, and that's how quick commerce is today, and these are some of the other innovations. All of us go to stores and shop, or used to go to stores and shop at one time. And it was, this is how you went to different aisles in the store to say, hey, what do I need? That's been recreated here. When you go into a category, just a sidebar with the subcategories there just makes the shopping so much easier. We see that it provides phenomenal value to and user experience to shoppers. So all of this is what's building quick commerce. And then, of course, you have to do the job of educating consumers. Wasn't easy. I remember when I back was at HUL, and I'm sure many of you in the room were a bit suspicious, circumspect, saying, is QuickCom going to take off? Who wants anything in a hurry? Right? But we had to educate people early on, and I'm just going to ask them to play the next four videos, which bring alive this concept of quick commerce, but in a rather entertaining way. Can you play the four videos? Yeah.
To 30 minutes. Meet tea instantly. Use Swiggy Instamart. Groceries and more delivered in 15 to 30 minutes. Meet tea instantly.
The next one.
Use Swiggy Instamart. Groceries and more delivered in 15 to 30 minutes.
Baba sir ne bahut pareshan karke rakha.
Master ji, patloon ek belan choti kar di thi.
Please le lo.
Bhai tu kaise mat hum pa gaya.
Tumne pistol na.
Need chocolates instantly? Use Swiggy Instamart. Groceries and more delivered in 15 to 30 minutes. Need salt instantly? Use Swiggy Instamart. Groceries and more delivered in 15 to 30 minutes. Need soap instantly? Use Swiggy Instamart. Groceries and more delivered in 15 to 30 minutes.
had a quite a fun way of educating people, reminding about the popular FMCG brands and the categories that they shop. But what happened with this is, perhaps many of you in this room who are hyper-convenience seekers came onto the platform very easily. But then we had to keep educating people that there are more use cases and what we call category entry points. And if you've not read the book, you should read it by Byron Sharp and team at the Ehrenberg Bass Institute on how brands grow. It talks about this, saying, can you, if you keep solving for category entry points and telling how your brand addresses that entry point, you're likely to keep building the network of associations for your brands. So we want to do that. We wanted to bring alive how quick commerce can help you in distressed use cases. And the idea that came about was saying, you know, Instamart can make even dads look good. Makes you go from papa to super papa. And this is the series of four different situations that we brought alive to bring alive distressed use cases. If you can play the next four super papa ads, please.
Water bottle, lunchbox. Papa is just super, na? Huh? And breakfast.
Super Papa.
10 minutes.
Get cereals and more in 10 minutes on Swiggy Instamart.
What's for lunch, Papa?
Don't say rajma.
No, pasta with mushrooms.
And extra feta cheese?
Huh?
Super Papa.
10 minutes.
Get feta cheese and more in 10 minutes on Swiggy Instamart.
Mamma mia.
Papa mia. Tell me now what happened.
Nothing.
Please, beta, tell Papa.
I ran out of pads.
Us?
Super Papa.
10 minutes.
Get sanitary pads and more in 10 minutes on Swiggy Instamart.
Thank you, Papa.
Hey, Super Papa.
Arey, Papa, ma'am said to bring geometry box tomorrow.
At 10 at night, she said this?
Papa.
What? Papa.
Super Papa.
10 minutes.
Get geometry boxes and more in 10 minutes on Swiggy Instamart.
And what if ma'am asked for sketch pens at midnight?
Papa.
So you can see again, the category had got redefined to 10 minutes, different use cases beyond just obvious grocery items. And a lot of these are born out of real consumer stories. And when we keep getting customer feedback, we hear some really, really interesting stories how people use it. Category then started getting redefined, right? It's not just grocery, it's a lot more use cases. So we had to then say, can we redefine the category? And sorry, before that, maybe this was just some fun that we had with another innovation on print, but I'll skip it in the interest of time. But we had to redefine the category, saying that what originally started off as 3,000 SKUs top-up mission is not true. You can have pretty much all your shopping needs happening on quick commerce. So you can get everything right here in 10 minutes, right? And we did that in a fun way with a little bit of help from the Indian men cricket team captain. So can we play the two Rohit Sharma films, please?
Ro, Instamart kar rahi hu. Want anything?
Wo.
Kitne?
Haan, aur wo bhi mangwa lena jisse battery...
Kya bolte ho?
Haan, aur wo kitchen wala jisse pull karte.
And done. ये से लेके वो तक स्विगी इंस्टामार्ट पे सब मिलेगा
इन जस्ट 10 मिनट्स तो फिर आज क्या लाओ प्लेयर ऑफ द मैच की ट्रॉफी या बॉलिंग डाल के 5 विकेट लो
वन बकेट आइस पार्टी पॉपर्स पार्टी हैट्स बोर्ड गेम्स डिशवॉश लिक्विड मॉप किचन टॉवल बाथरूम फ्रेशनर एयर फ्रेशनर सैंडविच स्प्रेड ब्लूटूथ स्पीकर्स वाइन ग्लासेस कॉकटेल ग्लासेस सर्विंग बोल्स बलून्स सोडा टॉनिक वाटर पार्टी हैट्स टिश्यू रोल्स
लिस्ट कितनी भी लंबी हो स्विगी इंस्टामार्ट पे सब मिलेगा इन जस्ट 10 मिनट्स
So the second one was actually shot before the World Cup win happened. We got lucky. They did a great thing that they won. And then we released it right after. And, you know, given Rohit Sharma's popularity and his Instagram followership, just putting these out on his handle got us between 10 to 20 million views straight away, right? So really, really landed the message. And then we did something interesting, but again, I'm going to skip that in the interest of time. Those of you who were from Bangalore or ever traveled to the airport at that time, we used the conveyor belt to land the fact that you can get anything, where there were a bunch of different items that came out on the conveyor belt along with baggage, with you know this visual there as well. So really using fun, having fun, bringing alive this proposition at different touch points. And then my last slide, which is this. So if we apply the same category entry points mindset to food, saying how do we then build association that food delivery or Swiggy can cater to you at various occasions. And these are just two campaigns or one campaign that we've now, the team has cracked this line, which I find quite an interesting line. And I'm going to play these videos shortly. But the first one is about Rakhi, which went live a week or so ago. And the second one's really going to go live over the weekend. So you'll be amongst the first few to see it. But this is the next wave of category building in education, saying, hey, there are different moments that you can keep ordering food in. So if you can play the last two films, please.
और क्या सीन है
शेफाली
निक्की
भैया ऑर्डर ले लो भैया
भैया तो मत बोल यार
सॉरी
ले भाई खा ले यू फील बेटर
सैया बनो या भैया सीन है तो स्विगी है स्विगी है तो सीन है
चेस डोंट यू जस्ट लव इट
हेलो सर
खाना उधर खाना
थैंक यू
ये क्या सीन है
सर पार्टी सीन है
बोगी बनो बोगी
ये क्या हो रहा है
पार्टी सैड हो या मैड हो सीन है तो स्विगी है स्विगी है तो सीन है
या जस्ट अगेन टू सच ओकेजंस आई एम प्रीटी श्योर would have felt relevant to a lot of you, at least the youngsters who got Rakhi tied by people they had crushes on. But certainly another way to say, hey, can we keep building the category association with many different entry points? So those were the examples I had. And that was my last slide. So really, in a nutshell, just want to say, remember that focus on building categories. Brands will get built in the process. Make sure you define the category well. Keep educating consumers about what you do and keep innovating on that front. I think that's the magic mantra, to be synonymous with the category and stay ahead of competitors who keep coming up. So that's what I had. Thank you so much.